And the idea with titanium backup is it copies all of the data on your phone, including any cached data, personal data, related to each application, and stores it for you. And it'll store it on the SD card or within the device itself, on its own memory. And then you can send all of that data the titanium backup has saved for you, and you can put it on a cloud storage service like Dropbox, like box.com, or Boxnet, should I say, and on Google Drive. So this is my titanium backup, and you can see the various settings that I currently have in use. If I go on to backup and restore, here are all of the apps currently stored on my device, but you can see here, I've just finished refreshing this device, so I don't have a huge amount on here of actual running apps, as it were, installed. But if I keep coming down this list, in a moment you'll start seeing things with lines through them. And these are the items that are stored on my, there we go, on my SD card, and these have been backed up by Titanium Backup. So as you can see here, lots and lots of games and other various applications. And if I want to restore one of these, all I have to do is select it. Let's just pick one that's not too big, because obviously the larger the file that you're trying to restore or backup, the longer it will take on the device. But let's just pick something quick and easy. Let's take Google Earth. And all I do is hit up and restore. I'll have the app only on this one, and it will start restoring. And that's it, done. Now I can come into my app tray, find Google Earth, and there's the application. And you can see, because that was stored actually on my SD card, the installation time, etc., it didn't have to wait to go and do any downloading or anything like that first. It just worked. Within Titanium Backup, let's go back in, you can set up schedules. So I have a few schedules here, and my most important ones are my sync to Dropbox and my sync to Google Drive. And what will happen is those will activate whenever the phone is on power and the timer is hit, 12:13, 14:26. And it will then run those, well, that's the last run times, but it will basically run any time it's on power and a timer is met. So if I go into edit here, so elements to sync, history coverage, remote location, and basically it will just run this anytime it's on power for this particular one. If it's on power, it starts uploading to Dropbox and Google Drive, and all of my stuff is stored there automatically, which means that if I need to, I can hop onto Dropbox. Say I have lost something off my SD card. I don't keep all nearly 7 gig, I think, of data backed up actually on my device, only the ones that I'm probably going to want to restore, if effectively anything over the last 6 weeks or so. But if I do need something that's older, I can go and grab it off Dropbox, pop it straight onto the phone, and then restore it quite happily. There is a wealth of options in here. You can do all sorts of clever things. So if you go in and create a new backup routine or routine, in here you have all sorts of different things that you can do as schedules. So verifying all of the backup routines, backing everything up, redoing the backups, keeping a history so that you can actually create staged backups. So effectively you can have backup one of an app, backup two of an app, backup three of an app, and as many as you want, or it will start overwriting once it reaches a certain point. So that allows you to keep different versions. So for instance, save games is one of the easiest ones to look at there. So, you know, save the game, save one, save two, save three. And because it's saving from Titanium Backup rather than within the game, you get a better kind of snapshot as you're going along, in my opinion. No chance of you overwriting your save games. So it works quite nicely from that perspective. But you have all sorts of stuff in here. It's well worth looking at as an app. If you come into the actual settings and preferences, even more options in here. Absolutely loads of stuff. This is an app that does take a little bit of getting used to. You'll have to play around with it a little bit. Every device is different, and every setup will be slightly different than what you're trying to do with it. Have a play around. If you find that an app gets jammed, so it won't actually restore or anything like that, or it seems to be taking a long time, go and check within your settings and just make sure that in developer options you've got USB debugging turned on. That's the primary problem that you get with Titanium Backup. If you haven't got USB debugging turned on, it can start failing, causing all sorts of weird problems. That's Titanium Backup.